Hello, K-drama lovers! New K-drama has come in JTBC, one of the broadcasting companies in South Korea, where famous dramas like Sky Castle and The World of Married, I'm pretty sure you guys already know this, were produced, which means we can expect this new series to be a mega hit again. The new drama is Mystic Pop-up Bar, in Korean, Sanggapucha. And this is based on popular webtoon of the same name and tells story of a mysterious 포장마차, which is outdoor food cart. This store, 포장마차, is run by a woman called 월주. And customers visit this place and talk about themselves and try to heal their internal wounds and trauma. And 월주 has two co-workers who help her, and after they listen to people's story, they enter the people's dream and granting their wishes and resolving their grudges. Speaking of grudge, Koreans have a very unique concept of an emotion which is called Han. Han is the collective feelings of sadness and oppression. And we believe someone dies of such big sadness and pressure, there will be a ghost who has Han, like a grudge. We call them 하늘 품은 귀신. In Korean, literally meaning a ghost bearing a grudge. So basically, Worju and her peers settle down their Hans when people are alive, then they won't be a haunted ghost later after they die. And now I want to talk about the meaning of the title, which is Sanggapucha in Korean. Here, pucha is the acronym for 포장마차, which is a tent-style outdoor restaurant on the street. It sells a variety of dishes like 쭈꾸미, 조개탕, 제육볶음, 오돌뼈, 연탄불고기, and drinks like soju, 맥주, 사이다, 콜라. Oh, now I'm hungry. This is where people often go to when they feel like drinking and eating in a casual atmosphere with friends or co-workers. But I guess nowadays it's pretty hard to find 포장마차 around us. People seem to stop going there due to the increasing price, and it's not that sanitary than other indoor restaurants. And now I guess you wonder what sangha means. Before we get there, I have to explain the concept of ga and eul first. I will explain it very easily. In Korea, we call the person with more power ga, and the person with less power, 을. It originally comes from the legal terminology, but is now used to talk about any relationship such as boss, employees, men, women, and adult and child, where you can find the gap of power. So if someone who has more power and more money shows a very arrogant and bossy attitude for the other and abuse their power to bully someone, we can describe him 갑질하다, 갑질하다. This is really common phrase in Korean. 갑 means spurrier, and 질 means the act of doing, and 하다 means to do. So it literally means boss around. So the most customers who come to this 포장마차 are being bossed around and have a hard time dealing with it. Now it's time to tell you what Sanggap is. Sanggap means you and me, both of us, are all spurriers. So Sang means mutual or both. So Sanggapucha has the meaning that this is the restaurant you went where you and me are equal, so you can feel free to talk about your story. So that's why we can see this poster here. 손님도 주인도 갑. Here, 손님 means customer, and 주인 is owner. So, customers, owners, we are all spurrier, we are all equal. So, you can feel free to talk about yourself. Now you understand what Sanggapucha means, right? Good. Well, this is not a very pleasant issue about Korean culture. But in reality, in our society, actually we have some people who believe that they are more superior than others. So whenever we see them doing like bossing around, we usually blame them like 갑질하지 마, 갑질하지 마.
갑질하지 마세요.
Which means don't buzz around. So 하지마 means don't. So 갑질하지마, don't buzz around. So if you guys have any chance to witness that kind of moment or situation, you might say to them,
갑질하지 마세요. 갑질하지 마세요. Like this.
I hope these videos help you understand Korean culture through the K-drama. And if you guys have any question about K-culture when you watch K-drama, please feel free to write down your opinions down below. Then I will check it out later and I might cover it later. Alright, this is for today and I'm going to see you next time. 그럼 다음 시간 또 봐요. Bye bye!